Yes, student. Earlier I have defined you the all the properties of the Laplace transform. Okay. Now here today I have defined you the inverse of Laplace transformation. Okay. So I will define first you the definition of the inverse of the Laplace transformation. Yes. If the Laplace transform of the function f t, yes, Laplace of f t, yes, this is equal to f of s, then f t is known as, then this f t is known as the inverse of the Laplace transform of the function f s. That is, this can be done inverse of the Laplace transform of the function f s. This is the definition of the inverse Laplace transform. Okay. Now, and the inverse, which is the inverse operator for the Laplace transformation, yes. Now, I have defined you the sum properties of Laplace transformation. Okay. I defined you the sum properties of Laplace transformation. Yes, properties of Laplace transformation. Okay. Now I have defined some properties. The first property is the linear property. Yes, linearity property. Yes. According to this property, if f1 and s1, yes, if f1s and f2s are the Laplace transform of f1t and f2t respectively, then the Laplace inverse c1f1s plus c2f2s, this is equal to c1 Laplace inverse, yes, f1s and plus c2 Laplace inverse f2s. Yes, clear? And this is again, this can be written as c1 f1t plus c2 f2t. Yes, this property you have proved earlier in that Laplace transformation. Yes. And the next property is the shifting property. Yes, second property is the shifting first shifting property and second shifting property. So the first shifting property is this here. In the first shifting property, yes, if Laplace inverse fs is equal to ft, then yes, then Laplace inverse f of s minus a is equal to e to the power a t f t. Yes. This is the first shifting property. You also proved this property earlier. Yes. Similarly as the Laplace transformation. And now we have proved the second shifting property. Yes. And according to the second shifting property, yes, second, third one is second shifting property. Yes, second sector. Yes. In this second shifting property, this is also given if Laplace inverse, yes, Fs is equal to Ft, then, yes, then Laplace inverse E to minus As Fs, this is equal to Gt, where, yes, where now Gt is equal to F of t minus a, for t is greater than a, and this is equal to 0 for t is less than a. Yes, and this property you can also prove earlier, yes, by breaking the two integral, and now you can solve it. Now we define the next one is the change of scalar property. Yes. Change of scale property. Yes. Change of scale property. Yes. If Laplace inverse Fs is equal to Ft, then Laplace inverse F of As, yes, scale, F of As is equal to 1 by A, F of 1 by A. Yes, this is also the easy, and you can also prove it earlier in the Laplace transformation. You can you have proved earlier all the properties of these types of the first shifting properties, second shifting property, linear property, and also the change of scalar property. Yes. Now I have defined you some example related to related by using these properties. Okay. In the next video, I have defined you some examples of these properties. Okay, thank you.